Australia is looking to secure a record-extending seventh one-day title when it takes on England in the Women's World Cup final in Christchurch on Sunday. The Aussies are red-hot favourites after smashing the West Indies by 157 runs in the semis. So if they do win, they'll hold both the T20 and one-day World Cup trophies, as well as the Ashes, which is no mean feat. And Talia McGrath joins us now from Christchurch. Talia, this is obviously a huge moment. How confident are you all feeling heading into this?
Super excited for sure. World Cup finals don't come around every day, so it's been something we've had locked into our calendars for a while now. And we take a lot of confidence going into the game. We've been playing some really good cricket and had some good results, so full of confidence and full of excitement.
Now, I know you've said before that you play better when you're a bit more relaxed. How are you going to make sure you feel relaxed enough going into this, given all the added pressure?
Yeah, there's a fair bit of hype around, but yeah, I'm like someone that likes to keep things pretty simple. I'll get to the ground and I'll have a kick of the footy like a true Australian. That'll get me pretty relaxed. And then for me, it's about knowing when to switch on and when to switch off. So take in the moment as much as possible, but at the same time, playing my role and doing what we can to lift that trophy at the end of the game.
Talia, you have an interesting definition of relaxing pre-game. We've seen some vision from your Instagram around what you've been up to in New Zealand. Is this safe? Is this not an unnecessary risk?
What is this?
At a time of a World Cup, what are you even doing? What is that apparatus?
Laying power cables.
Yeah, it looks like you're fixing the mountain or something.
Yeah, look, we went ziplining here in Christchurch before the tournament started. We had to get the all clear from, the doctor and our security manager, but got the tick of approval and living it up in New Zealand, seeing what it's got to offer.
One way to free up that batting order too, though. you bat at six and a few of those batters in front of you have been getting a few runs, so you haven't seen much action. So maybe a bit more extreme sports before the final?
Yeah, not a bad idea, that one. It's a nice role to have in the team when you're batting at six and don't have to do much. Our tall porters fired the whole tournament, and I think three of our players are in the top five run scorers for the tournament. So at the moment, I'm loving just sitting back, watching them do their thing and doing a bit of zip lining on the side.
Talia, Australian women's sport is riding a massive high at the moment, and there's speculation that Ash Barty might even pick up a cricket bat. What do you reckon your odds are on the tennis court? You want to practice the backhand or what?
I am absolutely hopeless at tennis, but on that, I think I might have to give her a call and try and get her to my Big Bash team, try and get her to come play for the Strikers. So, there's a few handy sports people out there that I wouldn't mind converting to cricket.
Talia, we know the team celebrates in style. Okay, let's just have a little look.
Let's go!
One of the last celebrations. Check out the moves. Let's imagine you do get the job done. Who's going to bring the moves this time around?
Darcy Brown. Keep an eye out for her. She'll be one to watch for sure. I don't have to think about that question.
Who's the New Zealand Katy Perry? Like, who have New Zealand got as entertainment in the final?
We haven't been told yet, but it's going to be hard to top Katy Perry. So give some of our girls a microphone and they can get on stage, I reckon.
Surely there's a Finn brother just lurking around.
I'm not sure.
Well, good luck on Sunday, Talia. All the best to the whole team, and hopefully we can talk to you again with a trophy in your hands. Talia, thanks so much.
No worries. Thanks for having me.